Thank you, Lord, for my beautiful wife.
Amen.
Thank you. Going on 38 years.
Yes.
Woo.
God is good.
Yes.
I think it's 38. See, we're 97. It'll be 38. You know God is good.
Yes, He is.
Yes, He is.
He's good all the time. I got this song I'm gonna sing before we go into anything.
Praise God.
Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for He is good. Yes, He is good. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for He is good. Yes, He is good. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for He is good. Yes, He is good. He's been good to me.
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 Oh, so good.
He's been good to me.
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 Oh, so good.
Oh, so good.
Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for He is good. Yes, He is good. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for He is good. Yes, He is good.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. He's been good. Hallelujah.
This time we're going to go to prayer. Hallelujah. Lord, we thank You on this morning, Lord God.
Thank you, God.
You found us in the house of God one more time,
yes,
Lord God.
Thank you, Lord.
We were predestined before the foundation of the world, yes, where we be at, Lord God. Hallelujah. You chose us, Lord God. We didn't choose You. Hallelujah.
Thank
and
you,
we thank You, Lord God, for the choice, Lord God, because You said many are called, but few are chosen,
yes,
Lord God. We just give You praise on this morning, Lord God. Hide me behind Your precious blood. Hide me behind Your cross, Lord God. Let me speak the oracles of God on this morning, Lord God. Let me speak a word unto the saints of the Most High, Lord God, that they might be able to live in this last and evil day, Lord God. And we give Your name the praise, honor, and the glory in Jesus' name. And my soul says amen.
Amen.
If you turn to Romans, the 8th chapter, verse 28 through 30. That's where you'll find us at. And then we're going to go to Psalms 34:1. God knows all about us. God knows. 28 says, and we know that all things work together for good to them that love God, to them who are called according to His purpose, for whom He did foreknow, He did predestinate to be conformed to the image of His Son, that He might be the firstborn among many brethren. Moreover, whom He did predestinate, them also He called. And whom He called, them He also justified. And whom He justified, them He also glorified. What shall we say? Said these things, if God be for us, who can be against us? He spared not His own Son, but delivered Him up for us all. How shall we not with Him also freely give us all things? Who shall lay anything to the charge of God's elect? It is God that justifieth. Who is he that condemneth? It is Christ that died, yea, rather, that He is risen again, who is even at the right hand of God, who also maketh intercession for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword? As it is written, for thy sake we are killed all the day long. We are accounted as sheep for the slaughter. Nay, in all these things we are more than conquerors through Him that loved us. For I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels nor principalities, nor angels nor things present, nor things to come, nor height nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus. Psalm 34:1 says, I will bless the Lord at all times, and His praise shall continually be in my mouth.
Yeah,
you may be seated in the presence of the Lord. We know this to be Resurrection Sunday. We know this to be also Passover, because we know that Christ died during the Passover, that feast, hallelujah, that they were required to live all that memorial they're supposed to give up unto the Lord every year. because of what he had done for them to bring them Israelite out of Egypt.
Yes.
We find here that only God could have brought them out, and he wanted them not to forget what he had done for them. And in that Passover, we find out that what had to happen was that night, God was going to kill the firstborn of every creature and every human. And all of a sudden, God had gave the prescribed prescription for him not to kill you if he came by, one of your persons in your household. And that prescription was you had to take a lamb of a year old without spot or blemish, and you had to cut his throat and drain his blood in a basin. And then all of a sudden you had to take hyssop and you had to dip it in the blood. And the word of God lets me know that you had to take that blood and put it on the lintel and on each side of the doorpost. And the word of God lets me know that when you did that, and even if the Egyptians did it, you hear what I'm just telling you? Even if the Egyptians didn't prescribe dose, guess what would happen to them? He would pass over. God is letting us know that once the blood is applied, he was letting us know in the Old Testament that what's going to happen in the New Testament. But all of a sudden, when he laid his life down, because no man could take it, the word of God said that Jesus gave up the ghost.
Yes.
So that means that God, nobody could kill him. All of a sudden, he gave up the ghost.
Yes.
And then all of a sudden, we find out that he was in the, all of a sudden, anybody could come into beloved. He was whosoever will. But back in the Old Testament, when they did that with the blood on each side of it, we're in a blood religion, whether you know it or not. We're in a sacrificial religion because without the shedding of blood, the word of God, let me know it, it's no remission of sin. You can't have no remission of sin if you don't have blood shed. Even back in the garden, God had to prepare an animal that was innocent for Adam because Adam had sinned. And the word of God, let me know that he took the animals and he took the skin off the animal and placed on Adam because Adam thought he was naked. And God asked him, who told you were naked? And all of a sudden, God asked him a question. You know, God asked such a question that we already know, that he already knows. He said, that woman you gave me, she did it, Lord. You know how we'll do it. We blame it on somebody else. They did it. He said, that woman that you gave me, she did it. And the Lord said, but I left you in charge, Adam. I come to get you. I didn't come to get Eve. You, I left you in charge.
Thank you, Lord.
But God had already made provision for Adam. And we find out that he was the first Adam. And all of a sudden came along the second Adam, which is Jesus Christ. In the form of a man. Fashioned after a man. Made of a man. Bone of my bone. And he said, I'm going to make a man. He said, God said, I'm going to prepare a body. And that body is going to be Jesus. And he's going to take away the sins of the world. He's going to be that sacrificial lamb. John said, behold, the Lamb of God, which taketh away the sins of the world.
Yes.
All of a sudden, Jesus came on the scene, and he was doing all manners of miraculous healings. And he was wiping disease away. He was healing leprosy, which was a disease of that day. That was a death sentence. And all of a sudden, Jesus said, your sins be forgiven you. And all of a sudden, the leprosy was cleansed off the leprosy. And you know they would say, unclean, unclean, you can't come here. Not like we do today. Today, when somebody's diseased, we let them separate around us. But back in the old day, they put them out.
All right.
They put them out of the camp.
All right.
Because they didn't want nobody else to get contaminated.
Yes.
That's why the word of God said, come out from among them and be you separate, save the Lord.
Yes.
Because you and I get contaminated with this stuff that's going on in the world.
My God.
We're in an evil day, y'all. We're in a day that I've never seen before. I'll be 62, the Lord let me see it in August. And I've seen some things today I've never seen in my life.
Amen.
I've seen them calling right wrong, and I've seen them call right wrong right.
Right. Amen.
And I see some saints of God going along with what the world's doing.
Yeah.
And they're calling it right.
Yeah. Jesus.
They're saying it's all right for two men to come down the aisle and the
Jesus.
Pastor. Pronounce them, I don't know what you pronounce.
Oh, God.
You pronounce them a mess. Because the head ain't right.
The he man and the she man.
The word of God said, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus.
Yeah.
If your mind's in Christ Jesus, you can't marry them two men.
No.
All right.
If your mind is in Christ Jesus, you can't marry them two women.
Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
The word of God said make a difference between
clean
and unclean, holy and unholy.
Yeah.
They done changed the way
for a man and a woman to cohabitate. Man has done some things in his own mind and saying it's all right.
That's a way.
But there's a way that seemeth right.
Come on, come on.
Unto a man.
Yeah, yes.
But the word of God let me know the end thereof is the way of death.
That's right.
You can't come to God any kind of way and stay that way. You can come to God any way you want. But you can't stay the way you came.
That's right.
And then pronounce yourself saved and Holy Ghost filled. And I'm holy. You can't preach the word of God if you're unholy. Because the word of God is against you. The word of God said, what I say to one, I say to all. Jesus didn't die on the cross so that we could continue in sin. He died that we would get out of sin and then go back to it no more. To remember it no more. Because the word of God let me know we are a new creature in Christ.
Yeah.
Behold, old things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new. Yeah. And the newness is what Jesus is talking about. You got to put on Jesus Christ and make no provision for the flesh.
Yes.
Because the word of God let me know there's no good thing dwelling in this old flesh about.
No.
Yes.
No good thing.
Because you know why it says ain't no good thing in this flesh? Because this flesh of mine is going back to the dust that it came from. But the soul has to go somewhere.
Yes.
And the word of God said, a soul that sinneth, it shall surely die.
What is saying?
So hold on to eternal life.
Yeah.
Cling on to Jesus, the one I'm talking about. Cling on to him. Hold on to him. Because he's a present help in time of trouble.
Yes, he is.
When your trouble comes and you're doing what the word of God says do, you can call him and he'll come to you.
All right.
You can be on your sick bed or going through some kidney stuff. Or have to get an operation to take something out. You can call him for that healing.
Yeah.
And he'll come by and see about it. He said, I heard you when you cried. I felt your pain.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I felt the pain of my sister. I felt the pain of my brother. And I'm coming to see about you. That's the kind of God that we serve. That's the Jesus I know. I've never seen the righteous forsaken nor received begging for bread. I've never seen it. I'm old. I was young, but now I'm old, but I've never seen
that
in this land. I've never seen it. God is calling us home, y'all. It's playtime's over.
Playtime's over.
Yes, Lord.
The curtain's rolling down.
All right.
Bless
you, Lord.
Whatever you want to do for Christ now, now's the time to do it if you're going to do it.
Yes, God.
If you're in the house, stay in the house.
All right, now.
You know somebody out the house, get them in.
Because
the house is on fire. And it's burning down. Satan got the house on fire. I heard that scripture. I will bless the Lord.
Come on. Yes.
I will bless the Lord. Yes. At all times. Yes. It don't make no difference with me. Some things might not be going right, but I'm a blessing.
Yes.
Some things could be going wrong, but I'm a blessing.
Yes, sir.
At all times, I'm going to give him a praise. Because he's been that kind of God.
Yes.
He's been good to me. When I was in sin, he was good to me. When I was out there doing anything I was big enough to do, he was good to me.
Come out here.
And then when I come over here and I put them things away,
good.
I put off the foolish things.
Yay, God.
I put off them things that don't please God no more.
All right.
I put them off. I lay them aside. But I got to lay up a sin and every weight that so easily beset. He said, put it aside, put it down. It's not worth it. To win Jack, to win Jesus.
Thank you, God.
It's just not worth it.
All right.
Ephesians 5:19 says, speak it to yourselves in songs and hymns and spiritual songs.
Yes.
Singing and making melody in your heart.
All right.
To the Lord.
To the Lord.
Whatever you do, do it all in the name of Jesus, but do it unto the Lord.
Glory.
Do it as unto the Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Is the Lord pleasing with me?
Yes.
Do it as unto him.
Yes.
Jesus.
20 says, giving thanks always.
Always.
For all. God.
Oh, thank.
And the Father, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, 21 says, submitting yourselves one to another in the fear of God.
Thank you, Lord.
That fear means I reverence Him.
Yes.
I've got enough sense here to know that my God lives and I'm a reverence Him. I'm a reverence Him for what He did, huh? How He got up on the third day, just like the scripture said.
Thank you, Lord.
And the word of God let me know He got up, but He just didn't get up. He got up with all power. The word of God said, all power is given unto me in heaven and in earth. With all power, that they don't leave nothing out. That means that Satan got to get permission to touch me or you. He got to go check with Jesus. Jesus cannot touch him. Ask Job. Ask Job what Jesus would do. Job was on his bed of affliction. And he said, have you considered my servant Job? He's a perfect and upright man. He'll screw evil.
Thank you, Lord.
His ear is always attuned to me. He's listening to what I'm telling him. His wife told him, said, Job, I know your affliction. Look like you're losing everything you got. Job said, she said, curse your God and die. Job said, you talk like a foolish woman. The good Lord giveth and the good Lord taketh away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Job held his integrity in God. Meaning that you and I have to hold our integrity when some things come against you. That don't mean you've been sinning. That's just a test. That's a testing of your faith. Hold on to God then. Hold on to Jesus when the tests come. Because He's going to bring you up.
Yes, He is.
Oh, yes, He is. He's going to bring you out. Every time you can be down sick, but all of a sudden, the effectual fervent prayer of the righteous, the word of God, let it know it'll avail us much. All of a sudden, the saints start to pray for you. They pray the prayer of faith. And all of a sudden, you get up. And you get up with the power of God because you know couldn't nobody get you up but God. Oh, yes, He could. He could get you up out of that bed when nobody could. The nurse could come and get you up, but you ain't got no strength in your legs. You can't walk. They can get you up every day. But God give you the strength to walk.
Yes.
He'll give you the strength to walk if you believe on Him.
Yes.
As the scripture said, the word of God said, a man born of a woman is of a few days and full of trouble. Trouble's on every side. It makes no difference whether you're saved or not. Trouble's coming your way.
Yeah.
But we got an advocate. His name is Jesus.
Yes.
In your time of trouble, you can call Him.
Thank
call
you.
Him like you mean it. Call Him in the morning. Call Him in the evening. Call Him in the noonday. His name is Jesus. His ears is always attuned to the righteous. The righteous cry, and the Lord hears them.
Yes.
And when they cry out, Jesus, He said, my son and my daughter, they're crying. I got to go down and see about them. I got to go and take care of them. I seen them down. I seen them sick. Sickness came upon them. I'm going to come and get them up again. I'm going to come and bring them back to the church. Somebody come pick me up. I need to go to the house of God. I know it's healing in the house of God. I know what healing is. I know what my Redeemer lives. My Redeemer lives in me. The Holy Ghost, the hope of glory. Oh, yes, shut up, bro. Down in our heart. I just give God praise on this morning. Because He's good. He's worthy of praise. He's righteous. He's holy. He's a holy God. Oh, yes, He is. His name is Jesus. Let my soul love Him. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Give you praise this morning. Whether life is going good, or whether life is going bad, or whether I am sick, whether I have a friend or don't have a friend, whether my health is good or it's not so good. I will say, like David said, I will bless the Lord. I will bless the Lord. I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continue to be in my mouth. David took care of the sheep out in the field. Oh, yes, he did. Even they called him a little scrawny lad. But let me tell you about sheep. Sheep stink. Yes, they do. They're not like on TV. When you see them, they smell. They don't take a bath like you bath your dog or cat. Oh, no, they don't. And they let me know. David was there with the sheep.
All right.
So David was a stinking fellow. When Samuel anointed David, he said, "Well, you got another man. You got another son.
Come on."
He said, "Yeah, he's out there with the sheep."
All right.
Let me tell you about being low. Yes. Let me tell you about being low.
Yes.
If you be low, God will get you up.
Yes.
Before that man, y'all went to New York, through New York. Before them people built that skyscraper, you know how low they had to go? They had to go down almost a mile to hit that hard rock so that skyscraper would stand up. So you see it up, but you don't see what's down.
All right, thank you.
God sent a way up. God does it in reverse. God does it in reverse. He said, "You want to get up? Get down.
My Lord.
Submit yourself.
Yes.
Humble yourself before the Almighty God." And the Word of God said, "He'll exalt you in due season." And he'll do it.
Yes.
Whether the storms of life are raging or calm, David came to a place in his life, no matter what comes his way, I will bless the Lord.
Yes.
At all times. God still gets the glory.
Yes.
Hallelujah. He said, "Give me the glory. Give me the praise. Lift me up." He said, "If I be lifted up, I'll draw all men unto me." He said, "Lift up the name of Jesus." God still gets the glory. Thank you, Jesus. The Lord, you are so worthy. Praise Jesus right now. Jesus, I'll never forget what you've done for me. Jesus, I'll never forget how you set me free. Jesus, I'll never forget how you brought me out. With a storm in. He brought me out.
Yes,
he brought me out of sin and degradation.
Yes, Lord.
I wasn't fit to live.
And I'm scared to
and
die.
I couldn't die. Jesus, I couldn't die in that state. He already knew. He said, "You so foolish, I got to go get you."
Thank you, Lord.
Because you can't come out your sin. Said, "I had to get on the cross and die for you. Die for your sins. That I could get you out."
Yes.
Because we didn't have enough power to come out.
Yes.
Sin had us. The Word of God says we were bound. We were bondsmen. A bondsman is in chains. And a bondsman can't get out of them chains unless somebody let him out. Jesus broke the chains of sin, death, hell, and the grave. Because he wanted to know. Then when he got up, grave, where's thy victory? And death, where's thy strength? Because Jesus took the death out of death.
Yes.
And took the victory out of the grave. Because every man that came this way went by the way of the graveside.
Thank you.
From the sting of death. Because the wage of sin was death.
Yes.
And Jesus hung there on the cross.
Yes, he did.
For you and I.
Thank you, Lord.
And the thing about it is, I thank God he hung there.
Yes, sir.
But I thank God he got up.
Yes.
I thank God he got up. You can look at all them other fellows, they worship. They're still there. They're still there. You can go find the remains right where they laid at. They went to look for Jesus in the tomb. The angels said, "Why look for the living among them?
Come on.
He's not here."
Yes.
He got up just like he said.
Yeah.
Ask Lazarus. He showed the people that he was the resurrection.
Come on.
Ask Lazarus. The Word of God said, "Jesus, you come now," but he's stinking. In other words, what you going to do now? He's stinking.
Right. Yeah. Come on.
He's stinking. The skin done wore off his bones, and the maggots is eating him up, them flies. He said, "He stinks."
Come on.
When it stinks, it's just right for Jesus. When it stinks, it's just right for Jesus. When they call you stinking, they did. is just right for Jesus.
Yeah.
Come to a man that told me everything about me. Come see a man. His name is Jesus. Come see him. He's got the medicine with him. He's got the scriptures, not prescription. He got the scriptures.
Yes, Lord.
That's his medicine. The word of God is Jesus' medicine. And he got it. He said, I got the pen. I can write you out a scripture. Get up. What did he tell Lazarus? Lazarus!
Come forth.
Come forth. He had to call him by his name. Because if he just said, come forth, all the grace would open up.
All right, now.
Everybody with God, if he just said, come, they would thought that was that day. That they're going to get up. He had to call Lazarus by his name. Because everybody else would have got up if he didn't.
Thank you, Jesus.
And the word of God says Lazarus came forth bound in his grave clothes.
All right.
Now, I don't know about you, but I'm looking at Lazarus, and all of a sudden, his skin started to grow back. Mm-hmm. And the organs started to pump back in his body.
Thank you, Jesus.
And the word of God let me know he had to loosen. He said, loosen and let it go. In other words, death had a grip on him. And the only one that can grip that and loose death is Jesus.
Yes.
Nobody else had done that before.
Thank you, Jesus.
Nobody had loosed nobody from the grave. 3 days. Surely, he was showing you who he is.
All right, come on.
The Son of the living God. His brothers didn't even leave him. You know, you ain't got the honor in your own house. What God said, prophet ain't got the honor in his own town. See, they didn't believe Jesus. You know who they told Jesus? Jesus told his mother to go with who? The apostles. Go with two of the apostles. Don't go back with them. They don't even believe. But you know what she said? Jesus, you can put one on the left hand and one on the right. You know what Jesus told her? That's not mine to give.
All right.
Who is my father? Who is my mother? Those that do the will of God. They are my father and my mother. It says, oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. Yes. His mercies endure forever. I will say unto the Lord, he is my refuge and my strength, and in him will I trust. God is our strong tower, a very present help in time of trouble. God is our refuge and our strength, a very present help. Saints of God, trouble don't last always. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto thee. Said, my soul shall make her boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. This poor man cried, and the Lord heard and delivered him out of all his trouble. God has been my help. God's ear is always attuned to the righteous. Nobody can do me like Jesus.
Right.
Not my mother, not my father, not my sister, not my brother. Nobody. Because there is power, wonder-working power in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
The blood of Jesus has never lost its power. It reaches the highest mountain.
Yes.
It flows through the lowest valley. The blood will never lose its power. God told Israel in Egypt, kill that lamb and put it on the doorpost.
Yes.
And when God sees the blood, he'll pass over. He said, I want you to do it as a memorial. Remember all the days of your life. Every year, do this. Jesus is our Passover lamb now. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes,
Jesus is our all in all. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Jesus alone is worthy.
Yes.
Oh, yes, he is. Glory to the name of Jesus.
Yes.
He the lily of the valley.
Yes.
He the bright and the morning star.
Yes.
He the Alpha. He the Omega.
Yes.
He the very beginning and the end.
Yes.
He my Savior. He the Master.
Yes.
He the Bishop of the soul.
Yes.
He the door.
Yes.
He the word. He the Lord of lords.
Yes.
He the King of kings.
Yes.
He the resurrection.
Yes.
He the truth. He the life. He the line of the tribe of Judah.
Yes.
He the way, the truth, and the life.
Jesus.
But if you can't remember all that,
Jesus.
Call his name Jesus.
Jesus.
Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I will bless the Lord at all times. Hallelujah. Oh my God. You got to get it in your sanctified soul. I will bless the Lord at all times. My God. At all times. Sickness and in health. Few dollars, no dollars. Take no heed. Take four, my God. Children acting great. Children acting all times. I will bless the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. We thank you, praise God, amen, for the word of God. We thank you, praise God, for Deacon Jarman, amen. We thank you, praise God. Hallelujah. Because the word comes, amen, to heal us, amen. It comes to set us free. It comes to encourage us, amen. If your heart has not been encouraged this morning, my God, you need to come to the altar, amen. Because it's the word, my God. It's the word of God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. The word, my God. Yeah, I get phone calls, but the word, my God. The word. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. The word of God, my God. Thank you, Lord. Because he lives.
Thank you, Lord.
He lived, amen, to fulfill the scriptures, saints.
Yes, he did.
Amen, that you and I might have a right to the tree of life. I'm so glad, amen, that he got up according to the scriptures.
Hallelujah.
He got up. Hallelujah. Tell somebody he got up.
He got up.
He got up. Hallelujah.